the Trans Adirondack Route. Starting just 8 miles from Canada in Ellenburg Center, the route runs approximately 240 miles to the Southern Blue Line. Along the way, the route uses 188 miles of hiking, cross-country ski, and snowmobile trails, 39 miles of dirt, gravel, and paved roads, and 11 miles of off-trail bushwhack navigation. Join me as I travel the route over a 15-day period, experiencing beauty, comfort, and camaraderie, while also enduring long days, wet weather, and my share of challenges.
See you guys.
And I'm off.
Good morning, cows. Oh yeah.
Thinking that's Lion Mountain in the distance.
Wait, what?
Hello?
Would you like to extend your car warranty?
What? No, I don't need to extend my car warranty. Jesus.
Good morning. It's time to start day two.
Turkeys. Hey there, guys. Good morning. about over road walking. Hello, goats.
This is a lot of fun.
Two days of walking, 30 plus miles. It's my first step on a trail. Mud pond. Let's find a campsite.
Get these boots off.
Get washed up, eat, and go to bed. Home for the night. There was no good source of water at that other site. It was all mucky. I got to pump and I got to get cleaned up, so. Okay. That's nice water. All right, now I just got to find a place that's flat. Make this home. Good night from Mud Pond.
Good morning. Boy, the winds kicked up last night. It's been blowing straight since 3 o'clock. It's 6:45 now. Good thing is, though, got all my clothes dry. Time for some off-trail. Not exactly sure where I'm at. I'm going in the general correct direction. Awfully wet. So probably waited to put the fresh socks on this morning. Just my feet are soaked now. Should have known better. Oh well. Bushwhacking around private property, or as Jackson would like to say, my son, weed whacking. High point of the bushwhack. There's Catamount and Whiteface. That's where I'm supposed to be going over tomorrow. From here, this seems awfully intimidating. Might be hiking by headlamp later today. After the last 2 days of road walking, I never thought I'd want to see a road again. Oh, thank the Lord. Some turkeys up ahead. Yesterday it was domestic turkeys. Today it's wild turkeys. Forty-three miles done. Less than 200 to go. And a nice guy told me that there's an 80% chance of rain tomorrow. I'm supposed to be going over Catamount and Whiteface, so me no likey. Hunting for a turnoff on the state land. Hit a property boundary, which makes sense based on what I drew on my map. So it's time to go bushwhack around this property. Well, I found myself in a lovely section of woods I have to go through. My God, what a day.
I completely underestimated this part.
Let's draw a line on the map. Oh man, this sucks. That was one of the most stressful hours my life. I'm in the middle of the deepest woods and I stumbled upon something I had no business finding. Scared the shit out of me. I took off running the deepest spruce swamp I could find. Oh, I could use some water. Woo! Taylor Pond. First water I've seen in hours. I was hoping for a burbling brook, but it will work. Dinner on the trail. Taylor Pond through the trees as the sun sets. Now I just need to figure out how to get to the trail across the other side and to the lean-to, which is way over there at the base of Catamount. Well, this is a lot of fun. And walking in circles at this campground trying to find a way to get on the other side of the lake. Finally found it. This is whack. I think this might be an earthen dam. Maybe you could cross it. But that's how you get across. That's what happens when you leave the guidebook directions that you need at home by accident. You gotta make it up as you go. Thank goodness for technology. It is 8 o'clock. I'm finally on the trail. Never been happier, I don't think, to see a lean-to. Oh yes, home for the night. All right, it's about 8:30. It's time to go bushwhack Catamount and start the day. What a great stay here last night. I love finding little openings in the woods. I don't know why. So welcoming. I think we are getting close. Let's go this way. Check out the beautiful view. Catamount Mountain. I believe that is the summit. Go up there and find the trail off of this thing. Unless I want hypothermia, I gotta get off. It's a shame it's not nicer. Here we go. Well, this is just lovely. Can't see a damn thing. Nothing is marked or blazed. Jesus Christ. So I gotta hunt around. This sucks. Get the f*** off of this. I'm not seeing anything worn or painted. Woohoo! Took a guess off that rock and I found me a trail. Boy, that turned from uncomfortable to deadly in the snap of a finger. The south side of this mountain is getting beat. This has been absolute brutal. I've never wanted to get off a mountain so badly. I have to think about what's up for the rest of the day. There is no way I'm doing white facing this, which throws my plans way out of whack. I wish I had a weather forecast. This just gets cooked out of here today. My GoPro screen took a beating coming down there. I got some cracks in it. So, I don't know if it'll affect image quality or not. Probably. I talked to my wife, she said there's a chance for rain later again. I might call an audible and just hike up the toll road. The goal's to hike across the Adirondack, so I need to get up and over that mountain before the weather gets bad. This is the life, sitting in a parking lot wet, eating tortillas, cheese, and shitty, disgusting sausage for lunch. Oh, yeah.
Oh, yeah, I can see that gouge in the screen now, and the sun hits it right, the light, there it is. Oh, well, get a new one in a couple days.
Follow the blue markers. Okay. That snowmobile trail ate my lunch. I'm thinking about going up and over Whiteface after this. What to make of the weather? I'm at the toll house for the Memorial Highway. I think I'm gonna change, doctor my feet, put something warm on. I'm just gonna head up the hill. It's 3:20. Hope the rain doesn't start, we'll just roll with it. Guess we're gonna go for it. Got a sweatshirt, pants, dry socks with wet boots. It's 3:45. I'm a little uneasy about it, but I think it's my best option. Sit down and walk. Up and over this mountain. That's all I want to do. I don't know about this. Let's see if I can find a place to hide out. Sleep in the castle or something. Gotta trust your gut. I'm getting a ride down with the Whiteface people. I'm gonna stick and stay the night in Wilmington after we wreck the plan. Beginning of day 5. What an adventure. Thank God for good people. Good way to wake up the legs. Come on, son. Wasted 2 hours hoping for that perfect sun breakup moment. So, got myself even in a more deficit today, starting with 5-6 miles I didn't do yesterday and starting extremely late, but whatever. Finding these there's the foot trail. Look at that. Well, if I just want to stay out there a little bit longer. Whiteface Brooklyn too. It's a good spot for lunch. road again. Do 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 do.
Drivers on 86 are idiots.
West Branch of the Ausable. There we go. Entering the Sentinel Range Wilderness, I'm transiting private property. The landowner's given permission for thru hikers. So when I hit 86 at 3 o'clock this afternoon, I had 30 miles to get done before 7:30 on Thursday. It's gonna be a push. I don't know how this is gonna pan out. Late afternoon light is such a delight. However, I give that up to be a few hours ahead of where I'm at now. Look at this gnarly yellow birch. What a beautiful specimen of a tree.
Look at this thing. Oh my goodness, it's so big.
Route finding. Still going up South Notch. As I spoke, I disturbed something in the distance. Hey there. Well, my GoPro battery just died as I was commenting on my walk, and that spooked a bear out of a tree. That was my first close encounter with a bear, and my battery died. He was in a beech tree eating beech nuts. Finally reached South Notch Pond. The last hour and a half has been brutal, thick woods and blowdown. Hopefully I can walk along this South Notch Pond a little bit and get out of these woods. I was here a couple hours ago. Told myself that this morning. I could be heading right to a cliff. Oh yeah. I finally made it to the road. So, based on what I just went through, which was pure hell, coming out of that South Notch, I think I'm just gonna keep going. Eat a Snickers while I walk. I don't think I'm gonna eat dinner tonight. I'm gonna find a place to camp. It is 8:30 and the stars are absolutely wonderful. 10:30, almost a 73 for the crossing. And I'll set up camp. Jeez Louise.
Final spot to sleep.